Diabetics and Nutrition at Kothari Medical Center. Today I am going to very interesting and very relevant topic in current scenario, that is boost your immunity, protect yourself.
How do we boost our immunity, ma'am? This is my question.
Yes. Good nutrition is very important before, after and during an infection. To fight with infection, we have to maintain a healthy balanced diet, which is very important in our present pandemic situation also. While no specific food or dietary supplement can prevent infection, maintaining a healthy balanced diet is important part of supporting a strong immune system. Immunity power is not developed in one day. Through dietary modification, we can boost our immunity power. To boost our immunity, choose a healthy lifestyle also. Good health guidelines is the single best step we can take toward naturally keeping our immune system, that is also strong and healthy. So we have to follow some guidelines like that. Eat a balanced diet where 5 food groups we incorporate in our daily plan. First of all, cereal. Rice, wheat, ragi, bajra, oats, quinoa, like that we can incorporate in our daily diet. This is our staple food and this is the energy giving food also. After that, pulses and legumes. That will comes from any kind of dal, soybean, rajma, beans, like that. We can take every day. And this is also the protein rich food. This is also help our muscle build. And next of all, milk and milk product, fish, egg. These are the first class protein we have to take every day. This is calcium rich and protein rich. This is also strengthen our body. And after that, fruits and vegetables. Of course, various colorful and seasonal vegetables and fruits we can take because of lots of vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, fibers are rich in fruits and vegetables. So we have to take every day to maintain our immunity and also it must be locally available and seasonal.
Okay. Ma'am, my question is, what food should we avoid?
Yes, we should avoid like junk food, sugar and energy giving energy rich food. We have to we don't take this kind of very energy giving food. And we have to take some specific foods to boost our immunity system.
That is my question.
Yes,
also.
Because of some specific foods gives and build our immunity system, like citrus food.
Okay.
Any kind of citrus foods are vitamin C rich.
Okay.
And it increases the production of WBC, that is white blood cell, which are key to fighting infections. It helps build up our immunity strong, like orange we can take every day. We need daily vitamin C for continue because our body does not produce or store it, but it should be proper amount. In present pandemic situation, we all are taking vitamin C rich food and vitamin C tablets, but it should be proper amount. We keep in our mind vitamin C rich foods, but excess vitamin C rich foods or tablets is harmful for us. So we have to take in proper amount. And after that, the bell pepper, that is capsicum, any kind of color like red, yellow, green, we can take every day because of it's rich in antioxidant, vitamin A and vitamin C, which is helpful for our health. And broccoli we can take it's also rich in vitamins and minerals. After that, garlic. It has immune boosting properties. It contains sulfur containing compound like allicin. We can take. And after that, ginger. It may help reduce a sore throat, decrease chronic pain, and also boost our immunity. And green leafy vegetables. Now this season, spinach is very much available, and spinach is also the rich source of vitamin C, antioxidant, and beta carotene, which may both increase the infection fighting ability of our immune system. And amlaki, guava. This is a very rich source of the vitamin C. We have to take. It is very much available in our local market. And yogurt you can take, because of yogurt's rich in vitamin D and also the prebiotics. This is also helpful for our digestive system and also increase our immunity system. And almonds is a vitamin E rich and also have healthy fats, which is powerful antioxidant, is key to a healthy immune system. And various type of seeds like sunflower seeds and flax seeds we can take if we can purchase it. And after that, turmeric. Turmeric is a key ingredient in our daily cooking practice, and it contains curcumin, which is immune booster and an antiviral property also. And we are regular take green tea and black tea. This is a rich source of flavonoids. It is a one kind of antioxidant, and also a source of amino acid, that is L-theamine, which is help to production of green production to fight against the germ.
Okay.
And we can take every day lots of fruits, various colorful fruits. That is antioxidant rich.
Ma'am, I have a question, that obesity affects our immune system. What's your opinion, ma'am?
Yes, obesity is one of the very serious problem in a day, in a current situation. In those with obesity, losing weight could make a big difference in the overall immune system. So cutting your overall calories intake, doing some exercises, and increase intake of adequate amounts of fruits, vegetables, fibers, protein rich food, which may help to losing the excess body weight and enhance the immunity power. So we have to control our weight according to our height.
Okay. Ma'am, other than food, what will be the another way which affect to improve our immunity?
Yes. Other than food, we can maintain our body weight through the moderate exercise. It is an excellent way to improve our immune system. Try to aim 30 minutes per day for 5 days of the week, or 150 minutes per week total. Include a mix of cardio and strength training exercise.
Okay. Ma'am, it has been very helpful. That can you tell us one balance and immune boost diet plan, ma'am?
You mean the whole day meal plan?
Exactly, ma'am.
Okay. First of all, the calorie, it's depend on the how much calorie we require. It depends on the patient height. First of all, we calculate the patient is in a correct ideal body weight or not. So first we calculate the BMI according to height and weight. After that we calculate the energy. Suppose one example, 1400 calorie the patient is required. So first of all we have to plan the diet according to the calorie. First we must take 4 meals, like breakfast, lunch, dinner. This is the main food, and evening snacks. That should be taken between the lunch and dinner. First breakfast, most of the persons skip the breakfast. This is the very bad thing for develop the weight. It is very much helpful, the skipping of the breakfast. So we have to take breakfast every day, and that should be cereals, any kind of proteins like cereals, handmade roti, cornflakes, oats, like that, and one vegetables, boiled vegetables or any kind of sabji, and one protein item that should be milk or milk product or boiled egg we can take, and fruits, seasonal and colorful fruit salads we can take as a breakfast. After that, lunch. And lunch we can take rice or roti, dal, vegetables, fish or chicken salad, and we can take the curd along with our lunch. After that, the evening snacks, we can take a little bit of light thing like sprouts we can take, because of sprouts is very much iron containing, and if we add some lemon juice, that should be helpful for the iron absorption, because vitamin C is very much helpful for the iron absorption. We can take sprouts or any kind of boiled vegetables or any kind of soups like tomato soup, sweet corn soup, vegetable soup, we can take this way. And after that, dinner. Dinner, little bit of light than breakfast and lunch. Many people take the heavy
in the dinner.
In the dinner. So this is a very much important thing. Dinner we can take any kind of cereals like rice or roti. We can take also oats and dali also, and lots of vegetables.
Yeah, that's true.
Vegetables is a rich source of fiber. It's not give the calorie, but our satiety value is fulfilled.
Yeah.
Okay. And any kind of proteins, that fish or chicken or paneer, soybean, and mixed dal, like that way, and salad we can take. And overall calorie, we must remember in our mind the cooking oil. This is the very important thing. It should be limited amount, and how much calorie, how much fat we are take, you should be consult a proper dietitian, qualified dietitian. And in this way, if you follow my advice, communication, and you definitely will develop your immunity system.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you.